Hello viewers, this is Leave straight from Kalkine Studio. You're watching Go Green with Kalkine. Today, let's talk about G7 nations and fossil fuels. A recent report by the charity Tearfund has found that since the pandemic began, G7 nations have favoured an investment in fossil fuels over renewable forms of energy. Let's understand why the G7 nations are significant in leading the path for a climate-safe future for all. G7 countries are the world's seven most powerful economies: the UK, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, and the US. Some of these countries are also the world's biggest emitters. Although they represent just one-tenth of the global population, almost a quarter of the global carbon dioxide emissions come from these world powers. G7 nations also hold the capacity to either strengthen the transition into green energy or worsen the already daunting climate change challenge. So, what does the Tearfund report tell us? The UK is host to the 2021 G7 summit. Ahead of this, the development charity Tearfund, the International Institute for Sustainable Development, and the Overseas Development Institute got together to publish the report to analyse energy investments by the G7 nations. According to the report, these seven countries have been injecting more money into fossil fuels than green energy. The G7 countries had set out to achieve net zero targets to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius. While the countries collectively pledged to build back better, the report found that since the pandemic began, they've invested $189 billion in coal, oil and gas. And that's in contrast to $147 billion in green energy. The report also concluded that 8 in every $10 invested into fossil fuels during this period had no green strings attached. The investments profited the dirtiest sectors that cause maximum harm to the environment. Addressing the adversities caused by the excessive release of carbon emissions, Tearfund's head of advocacy, Paul Cook, said, "Every day, Tearfund witnesses the worsening consequences of the climate crisis for communities around the world. Farmers' crops failing, floods and fires engulfing towns and villages, families facing an uncertain future." So, what recommendations does the report make for G7 countries and the road ahead? It recommends G7 nations can adopt a do no harm principle in a view to ending their support for fossil fuels. They're also recommending to attach green strings if aid is provided to the fossil fuel intensive sectors. G7 nations are being urged to invest at least 40% of the total COVID-19 recovery spending for sustainable development projects. The countries have a powerful impact on multilateral development banks. They can use their position to influence these banks to align their activities with the Paris Climate Agreement. The countries can also collectively help low and middle income countries in their green recovery by easing their debt burden. The report calls for more climate finance pledges and ending overseas finance for fossil fuels by these powerful nations. The world's richest seven countries hold significant value in the fight against climate change, but their support for fossil fuels will challenge the ambition of reducing greenhouse gas emissions and the idea of pushing the world towards achieving carbon neutrality. If you like this information, please like, share, and comment on the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for notifications for our latest videos. For regular updates and information, log on to our website, kalkinemedia.com. That's all for now. I will be back soon with more shows around clean energy, renewables, and climate change. Thanks for watching. I'm Leave for Kalkine Media.